It's always the same dream. Blinding light. A cold, umbral growl. I'm reaching, clawing towards hope. Towards oblivion. Pain. Real spiked thunder drove straight through my palm. My heart keeps beating. I stumble. Grasp out in delirium. Then, black. I dream about my mistakes. About the life I destroyed. All I have left is my scar. To remind me of the things I've done. Just another day in. One day at a time. You got this. Even 2 years after the accident, I'm still getting these migraines. Feels like someone's trying to claw right into my skull. I think I left my painkillers in the nightstand. Not perfect, but better. Good enough to get me through the next few hours at least. To you too, Dale. Why are you calling my landline?
Oh, I tried calling the cell first, but it just kept going to voicemail. Aren't you supposed to leave that bad boy on in case there's a plane crash or something?
Not anymore.
Hey, you may have lost your license, but you've got a gift, man.
Fixing knees and backs is easy. It's me I don't know how to fix. Dale, you're right. I'm not feeling any better sitting here. I'll swing by the ranch tonight, yeah? And thanks. I'd forgotten my amnesiaversary was coming up.
Well, that's why you got me to remember for you.
Guess this morning is just full of surprises. I've seen this symbol somewhere before. Who could have sent this? Thank you.
Is the camera working? All right, looks like it. All right.
Good evening. I'm Jill Lane, reporting for AOC News Live from Devil's Womb Canyon. Breaking news as authorities report that 3 buses full of students have disappeared without a trace. The school group was returning from their annual class trip to Camp Watonic when parent...
Shit. Is everything just breaking today? I think I still have one of my old work computers in the storage closet. Shit.
Pitiful refuse. Dreams make dead of my designs. Rejected cur. Slither on your belly to me and grovel. Your insignificance amuses me.
This is Jill Lane speaking to Dr. Thomas Jackson, surgeon and lead physician for the Hope Project. First question, how do you do it? 14-hour days, 6 days a week?
You get used to the hours, and a medically unsafe quantity of coffee.
That may be true, but you see so much suffering. How do you handle it?
Someone has to.
How noble, Mr. Superman.
It's Dr. Superman, thank you. But please, just call me Thomas.
Honored words are shiny trinkets, apples of power and promise so easily purchase your pathetic imaginations. Few are worthy of such privilege to hear whispers from a god.
And how are the gravitation readings? Any promising leads?
Jacob, fuck the gravitation readings. Four people, my friends, are dead.
Yes, I know. Don't think for a second that doesn't haunt me. But if we turn back now, it'll be for nothing.
And if we keep going, how many more will die?
None, if I can help it. Second activation won't be like the first. I'm taking precautions. Speak of the devil, I've invited the team to the medical doctor. I need you two to work together to make sure that this does not happen again.
To pass that Nur did lay his beating heart within a vessel. The seal of Nur, forged so those few marked may pass as did Nur between the glass of living and dead, to call back those that have since gone, to walk through the veil between waking worlds, and to cast back those that do not belong.
Oh.
was all of that. That wasn't a dream.
That suddenly all calls and messages coming from the children inside stopped at the same time. The police have not been able to locate any brake marks or signs of collision along the road. With only the town of Gorberg nearby, options are limited for...
Shit! Jill! What in the fuck is going
on? Golden Vestas, fathomless desire, power. Alter your words to sway lesser men. My patience wears thin. You took from me. Now I have taken from you. Follow her path. The doorway will be open to you. Return it to me, and I shall return her to you.
Jill. I don't know what's happening. This is insane. But it doesn't matter. I'm coming. Gotta try and find someone. Looks like it got trapped in that webbing. I'd better stay away from it. Billionaire Jacob Earldred promises new future for renewable energy with Project Mirror Forge. Isn't he the guy who invented some banking app?
Sulfur powder inside. Carbon rods inside. Okay, you'll need to place a copper wire now. Acid into the beaker.
Mm-hmm.
to turn on the engine to bring power to the hob. Just wait for it to heat up. Okay, last up, pour the alien liquid we've extracted from the webbings into the beaker. Acid strong enough to burn through anything.
What the hell happened to this town? It's like no one is here. Seems to be getting worse further in town. Shit. That's a lot of blood.
Days of waiting. Some of the people have already entered the facility, but my team is still here. What's going on? These Gorberg folk are not the chatty type then.
These military crates are all over the place. What happened here?
Thank you.
chills. Gunshots mean people.
Squad got pinned down at the diner. We cannot proceed to the facility. Monsters, cultists, yeah, they're everywhere. We've lost the two of the prisoners. That's that strange anomaly roaming the streets. The news reporter and the cameraman are still with us.
Piece by piece, I'll rend your flesh from bones, tear essence from soul, leave from you a thousandfold what was taken.
12 more fucking people. We flip the switch and people die. I don't even give a shit about the science anymore. This is madness. Jacob is already talking about a third activation. I can't let that happen. I'll need to get the doctor on my side for this. He can still get through to Jacob. And maybe we can stop this.
Each of these statues has Roman numerals on them. Maybe they mean something.
What the fuck do you want?
voice. Where have I? What was that? The last digit. I should try the code on the safe in the diner's office. Maybe I'll find some info on where they took Jill. Is this what that voice was talking about? Doesn't look like much. No idea what'll actually happen if I break it. What was that? It was coming from that small house just after the playground. Stuck.
This is Jill Lane, a field correspondent from Ajax News, reporting from Gorberg, I think. I don't know how we got here. This place is just wrong. These people, they kidnapped us. They're taking me and my cameraman Todd to somewhere called the Forge. And I'm scared. There's something in the dark. Shit. Thank you.
What happened here? Bet I can hit the other switch from here.
Our minds and warps our reality and perception. It delights in our fear and suffering, breaking us until we have lost all sanity.
Clark, where have I heard that name? What is happening to me? Like some sort of energy storage.
I managed to finish the security power system modifications on time. The system now will perform checks on a regular basis, ensuring that no power storage is plugged in unless the magnetic coils are powered up. Always turn the valve next to the slots before you plug any power storage. Thank you.
Thank you.
our old apartment.
Hey, honey, I went to go check out the house today. Looks like the whole ordeal with the roof is finally over. Just one more reason for us to celebrate. I just wanted to let you know that I left to drop some things off at Abby's real quick. Wait for me to get back home, okay? I have more amazing news I want to talk to you about.
I think I put the candles in the wardrobe. Where did I leave the flower box? Ah, another text message. Better check it out.
Hey baby, there's just too much traffic downtown. How about you meet me at Dave's Shitty Dive? You know how much I love his open mic karaoke. Waiting for you there. Love you.
She seems so excited. Wonder what she's got up her sleeve. Alright, hon. Drag me all the way out to be serenaded by Fat Tony's creative rendition of Hotel California. Must be something special.
You're gonna ask him for an encore in a second here, trust me. Hey, Tommy. Look.
I'm gonna be a father?
We're gonna have a baby!
But how? You're scarring.
I'm just as surprised as you. The doctors are stumped. It's not totally a miracle, but pretty close.
Holy fucking shit, babe. All right. Dave is busting out the expensive shit. Everyone in the house is getting shots.
All right, Doc. Good thing you're not on call. Let's do another one, then hit the road. I gotta interview a kid in the morning that's making solar panels for halfway houses.
Oh, Jesus. I need at least another one after hearing that. I swear to God, sometimes these people are just made up.
I mean, I literally met you when you were wrist deep in an orphan's spine, giving him a chance to walk again.
Yeah, but that's just work.
Come on, don't do your self-deprecating crap now. You're the best man I've ever met.
Thanks. Just wish I always felt that way. But I do when I'm with you. Jill? Jill! No. No. No! Wake up! Need a screwdriver to open it. Need a screwdriver to open it.
Come back. You know, I was in a coma for a month with a broken femur, a broken ankle, a severe concussion. And all of that would have been fine. But I lost my baby, my miracle child, my once in a lifetime shot at being a mother. And I'm still hurting from that. You can't just keep drowning in guilt and guilt. So don't call me. You can't call sober.
Thank you.
I should look around for the lever.
They are losing hope. The second activation broke their resolve. No one has had the metal to say anything to my face. And I can hear them whispering. See the cowardice in their furtive glances. Weak-minded fools. Can they not see that we are on the precipice of greatness? We activated the forge. It was... beautiful. Golden vistas. Fathomless desire. Power, thou measure. You're so close to breaking through. I will not be denied. Thank you.
I'm surprised you got out of there alive looking at your injuries. And to think, he got out of it with just a broken hand.
What lab? I don't see a lab. Hello? Hi. What's your name?
Leave me alone!
Okay. Okay. What's the matter? Why are you here all by yourself?
I don't like the doctors. They're all around.
Which doctors? There's nobody here.
They don't see me. Nobody sees me. My mom was the only one that cared. I lost your photo, and I don't know how to be brave without it.
Yeah? Would you feel better if I got that picture for you?
You would?
I'll get it for you. And in return, you'll tell me how to get out of this hellhole.
Deal! I think I left it in room 3.
So, Dr. Superman, what's your kryptonite?
Oh, geez, tough questions from intrepid reporters. I don't know. I guess talking about myself. Ask me about flesh-eating bacteria or spinal fusions. It's easier.
Don't be so shy. This is the kind of human story that people want.
It's not that. It's just 15 years ago, I lost my memory. Some kind of accident. Total amnesia.
Seriously?
Yep. Woke up in a cornfield 20 miles out of town. Was scooped up by a farmer and his wife. Didn't know a thing about myself. Other than that, somehow I knew medicine and I needed to help people.
Hang on a minute. You woke up in a cornfield. Were taken in by a farmer and his wife. Took on a mission to save the world. And you're just now telling me to call you Dr. Superman?
All right, I'm seeing it now. I swear to God I didn't make the connection.
seriously, though, I get it. Tragedy from the past inspiring you to dedicate your life to something noble. You know, 15 years ago, there was an accident. I'm really not sure what happened. I wasn't living the best life back then.
It's okay if you don't want to talk about it, but I'm happy to listen.
Not much to tell, honestly. You know, I was out with some friends one moment, the next moment I woke up in the hospital. I had a big wound right there on my stomach. And well, on the outside of it, it really doesn't look so bad. Most of the damage and scarring is internal.
Those can be the worst.
Yeah, well, doesn't really get in the way anymore. Just, I can't really have kids at all.
Ah, shit. I'm so sorry.
Oh, it's okay. I've always kind of wanted a little girl, but, Oh my god, I am so sorry. This has gotten way off the rails here. You know, who's interviewing who?
Hey, I'd rather read about you anyways.
Jesus Christ. Is that what I think it is? Now, where the hell did she go? Whatever you are, whatever's out there that's fucking with me, you won't stop me. Jill, no. This isn't real. This isn't real. I'll find you, Jill. I'll find you.
Oh.
the Anunnaki?
That's it. This is the third fucking time you've tried to pull this shit. A surgeon with an impaired hand is one thing, okay? But a surgeon who keeps trying to operate drunk? That's another. I'm sorry, but you're out. Go get some fucking help.
Hello?
I broke it. She's frozen. Cold like a doll. She hates me. She won't let me mend her wounds. Won't talk to me anymore. And I'm so lonely down here.
Yeah, man. Spooky shit. I really just need to get to Gorberg.
I see you're broken too. Your thoughts are shattered. Your mind numb.
Hey, can we cut the cryptic shit?
Fine. Take that door over there and you're on your way.
What door? Hopefully I don't see him again too soon.
worthless. They already said the mirror forge won't work without organic matter. Why are we still keeping them in this facility is beyond me. The first test when we used them was a complete failure.
I sing your veins. My nails pick ascendant from inside you. Dance back to me, insect.
What the hell? The mirror doesn't seem to be working anymore. Should have cleared the way back there. The year I woke up. Can't remember a thing before it. Wallet in my pocket said my name was Thomas Jackson, and somehow I knew medicine.
The winglets of newborn, it's half-pitched howling. blood of angels ran hot into my womb. Eternal cries of the unborn ripped from ether before taking form. Such things are commonplace torment. True desolation is far more insidious. Agony. I must find my salvation.
Hey, come back here, you little...
Written on the ancient Sumerian tablets. They believed it was a godly entity. We know it's an interdimensional being, omnipresent and all-powerful.
find the other piece.
What the hell are you doing here?
Sorry, man. Not trying to trouble you. I'm just trying to get to something called the Forge. Wait, how do you know my name?
Of course you won't remember. The Mirror Forge blast. The transition barrier to other dimensions heavily affects your mind. Like what an EMP does to electronics. You remember nothing of your past life.
What the fuck are you talking about?
You were born here, Thomas, in this dimension. You were part of Project Mirror Forge. You were our doctor.
Ah!
The Anunnaki, gods from 3500 BC, ancient Mesopotamia, are interdimensional, all-powerful beings. When the Mirror Forge was activated, we caused a crack in the multiverse. We fucked it up.
Wait, so...
More specifically, it was like a hammer, causing a crack in the prison of the primordial demoness, Lamashtu, the devourer of realities. The Anunnaki locked her up. The only way to open the cage is a key. That, or just smashing her dimension into ours until enough cracks open for her to slither through.
How do you...
But what I can't figure out is how you got the mark of Anu, the prime god infused on your palm. It's the key that unlocks her prison. If she gets you, not just this reality, but all realities will be consumed by her.
Whoa, whoa, wait, hold up. Stop for a second. I got this in a car accident 2 years ago.
Oh, really? Yeah, ever seen a scar bear so much resemblance to the cuneiform symbol of Anu, Thomas? Wonder why you can seemingly hop dimensions? No. That's the mark of Anu. It does explain where you went 20 years ago. I honestly just thought you were dead.
How do you know all this? How do I know you're not just another trick?
I know because I was there. We were friends once, and all things considered, it is good to see you, Thomas. But listen to me. Lamashtu must not find you. Just look at what she's done to our reality, and this is just a fraction of her true power, but she can't fully escape without the mark of Anu. Go back now.
I can't do that. They took Jill, the woman I love. I took an oath to protect her. And I failed that once. I won't let her suffer again because of me.
You were once willing to sacrifice all of us for the dreams of some madman. And now you're gonna sacrifice the whole world for some woman?
I can still save her. There's nothing else to discuss.
There's the Thomas I know. Okay, go back the way you came. This way is blocked. And Thomas, maybe it's better you don't remember.
That should do it. Now to pull the lever.
The seal of Nur is gone. Who the fuck knows where it went? Without it, I can't even try to hop dimensions to get out of here. There's always the sigils.
I can't believe we're even considering this. If we do this, we're no better than those madmen that worship her.
Bury the sanctimonious bullshit. If they get a hold of the Mark's bearer, that's it for everyone. Lamashtu will be free. We just want to escape to a safer reality.
She has a name, you know. It's Jill. And you're talking about killing her.
We don't have time for this. We need to take her to Aldred's Manor. People, come on. Let's move.
Aldred's Manor. Is that where it all started?
Thomas, I think he's been lying to us. I know it sounds crazy, but ever since we first turned out that fucking machine, Aldred has been obsessed with piercing the veil. And every time we do, it goes to shit. Don't you ever wonder what exactly he's seeing through those cracks? Someone. If anything happens to me, just know I didn't do it to myself. Okay?
Duck. Safety door at the front of the train should be open.
Thank you.
I can't believe we were so wrong. We weren't just tapping into a plane of infinite power. We were tapping into a thing. There's something on the other side whispering. I can't believe I was so blind. Jane was right. Earldred is leading us to damnation, and now she's dead.
Thank you.